And we've come just at the right time because Antron's dragster needs a bit of routine maintenance. Oil change, tyre pressure, cutting the whole car in half, the usual stuff.
Tell me why you have to change the front end.
Our cars go through so much stress going down the racetrack. It has no suspension on it, so the chassis does all the work. It's made to flex and give going down the racetrack. And so many cycles of that, the tubing, the chromoly tubing starts fatiguing. And once it fatigues...
You need to change it.
We gotta change it out. And cylinder heads, just bring them right on through.
Things like, just moving. Slow down. Everyone just slow down. The engine is now in bits. There, on the bench, look. Follow me.
Look at it.
Look, we're down to the block. Right, it only just turned up. I mean, the car turned up, what? Seriously, is it less than a minute, 2 minutes?
Yeah, we've only been there for about 2.5 minutes right now on my stopwatch.
I just can't believe how fast. I said they're going to work fast, and they do work fast. So this is the fuel cell.
Yes.
Right, so in there, is there enough gasoline in there for one run?
Yes, for one run, but the craziest part about it is that the tank, and look at the fuel line. That's the fuel line that feeds the car.
Look at that.
That's the fuel line.
Look at that. That's like the pipe that goes into a gas station.
That's it.
That's incredible. So how many gallons is it?
We actually have a fuel pump that can pump over 110 gallons per minute.
Oh, stop.
At 700 PSI. So it will suck. This is the funniest part. When we go wide open on the gas pedal for 3.6 seconds, this car will burn almost 7 gallons of fuel in 3.7 seconds.
Stop it, really?
Oh, yes. Just like, boom. Like, our car sits at idle for 20 seconds. Every 20 seconds at idle, it burns a gallon of fuel.
So you think about the forces at play, and I often think about this, particularly with an engine broken down behind us, and we're looking into the cylinder heads here, right? If you think about the forces, you're talking about 7 gallons of fuel that's going to be burned, 7 gallons on the 3.7 seconds.
Yes. Yeah?
7 gallons of fuel is all going to be exploded in these chambers in 3 seconds.
Absolutely.
So there is a lot of forces at play there.
Yes, and what makes it so delicate, that's what it takes. It takes that amount of fuel volume to actually make the 11,000 horsepower that these engines make.
11,000 horsepower.
Yes, I ain't talking about 1,000. I'm talking about 11,000.
Yeah, so you've got your amp cranked up to 11. You don't have your amp at 10.
That's it. When you step on the gas pedal,
you know it.
You shake the ground with these cars.
Seeing on my cars, whenever I'm restoring a car and we take the rear diff apart, we see a ring and pinging gear that's about that big. But that's the size of one. You need to harness 11,000 horsepower. And how many foot-pound of torque?
We're about over 16,000 foot-pounds of torque.
That 16,000 foot-pound of torque, isn't that enough to stop the world spinning and then get it going backwards?
Well, when you accelerate. When we step on the gas pedal, we do actually stop the earth just for a little bit.
So this is the engine that's come out of your, look at the size of it, of your car. So this is based on an engine that's been around forever, the 426 Hemi.
Yes, it is. And we got a 4 3/16-inch bore with a 4.5-inch stroke to make it like a 496.
Right, so big block.
Yes.
If you like. So with an engine like this, do you just ship these in, you buy them in?
Oh, no, we make this all in-house.
No, you don't. What?
Yes, we do. Yes,
seriously,
we do.
You make those engines?
Brother, we take a block of a plane of aluminum, and we wheedle it out.
No, you don't. Seriously?
To a finished product. Come here, check it out. I've got something for you.
Car strips, look, already.
Yes. By the time we get back, it'll be ready to go up front.
This building just continues.
Yes.
Hey,
I'm all right, how are you? Good to see you. Very nice to meet you, sir.
Jeff's our engine block guy.
Is he?
Very tedious.
Get it. Seriously.
We got nothing but the best equipment. All Akuma based here with Sandvik tooling. And the coolest part is that you can look down this line, you hear the machines just constantly going. Some doors are open because they're about to load them, but it just keeps going.
It's just fantastic, Antron.
See, look at it.
Is this Frank?
That's Frank right there.
How you doing, Frank?
Love your show.
Oh, thank you, Frank. I appreciate it. I really appreciate it. It's very nice of you. So you're actually, they're manufacturing their own cylinder box.
Yes, right there. And right there, you see it right there? It's a cylinder head right there. He's doing right now. Touching off on it, going through it, finishing up. That's actually a
so
repair
where,
job.
So how does that start then? Have we got a piece of, block? How
yes,
that starts?
Right here. So this is how a cylinder head starts. Ingot, billet, aluminum.
You give it to Frank. He presses a few buttons on the computer.
And bam,
voila. Look at that.
This is where we have our printer, where we can print off
all
our stuff.
You've got one of my favorite machines in the whole world. And we can go in there?
Yes,
can we really?
Yes, we can.
Oh, I'm going to love this, right? I'm a geek, but I don't want to disturb these guys if they're working.
No, it's okay.
Oh, I can't believe it. Look at that. That's a 3D printed cylinder block.
Yes, and actually, you know, just everything from cylinder head to the block.
I just want to hug it.
I
love them because it's the replicator out of Star Trek, isn't it?
Yes.
You know, we just stand there and say, I want something, and it makes it for you.
Boop. And then you can see here where we have designed, and we actually made a small version of our engine with an injector and everything on it.
Absolutely incredible.
I told you, like, when I come to the shop, it's like Christmas.
If you could just paint that silver for me, boys, and wrap it up, I'd like to take that with me.
While I've been playing tourist, Antron's team has completely stripped down his dragster. This is the fun bit.
Ah, here it is. Your chassis is coming in.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it wasn't long ago. That was a complete car. I mean, a whole car. But now, look at it. And here it is. So this is now going to get trimmed off here, and you say you'll save the front end.
Yeah, we'll save the front end. You can see the weld right here.
Yep.
You'll actually get Ziz with a Ziz wheel right here. Oh, look, like butter. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. It's like butter. And then they can actually just slide them off, and now we can slide that on. Now slide right onto the new one right here. So when they weld it on, it'll be ready to go.
Where's the pin go?
Got it. There you go.
Here we go. The marriage of the old and the new. And it goes.
That's
These guys
now.
Are going to get the...
He's going to get the mallet.
The mallet, the universal screwdriver. Hey, Blake.
Oh, mate.
How you doing, brother?
Good seeing you.
Oh, this is not even right. What is this about, huh?
I can't leave Brad without taking a shot at a three-time champ.
You got my right-hand man on this game, didn't you?
Yes, I did. I reached out to Blake, and I said, Blake, last time me and Antron got together, he beat a wheeler dealer, and I can't allow that to happen again. So I've arranged for not you to turn up in your drag car little Toyota Camry. I've got us exactly the same Toyota Camrys. Me and you, we're going to go head-to-head. Obviously, I've got a few pounds on you. You're a little bit lighter. So I need to even this up a little bit more.
Well, how are you going to even it up?
It's easy. You're going to take a passenger. Blake's coming along for the ride. Yeah, come on. You can have the silver one. I'll have the red one.
Hey, Blake, I got news for you.
What's that?
You're fired. No more. No.
I'm hiring Blake, and you go and sit in that car for me.
Normally, we'd all be done up in fire suits and helmets and have paramedics standing by. But these Toyota Camrys aren't going to quite get up to 330 miles an hour. I hope.
So here we go. You look terrified. Don't worry. Don't worry. I think you've got this, Antron.
Remember.
You just remember one thing. I got a little bit of something in here for you. You just don't know what it is.
Gee, this is a little bit of nerves kicking in now. Here we go. And we're away.
He redlined! He redlined! I won!
Oh, my God! I'm beating him! I'm beating him three times! Sophie, I got him off the line! Oh. You got no chance, brother! No chance! Yay! Oh, that is fantastic. Can you believe that? Can you believe that, Antron? Antron, now you know what it feels like to lose just once.
Oh, I got swankered right there. You got me.